Radcliffe is back on Broadway, starring in the new one-act comedy, The Lifespan of a Fact, about the importance of reporting the truth, yeah, and the desire for some people, anyway, to get every fact correct. Hello, timely.
Yes.
I saw it the other night, and I really loved it. Please welcome Daniel Radcliffe.
That's very kind of you. Thank you very much.
Hello. Welcome to the show.
Hello,
so
thank you.
You're an incredible actor. You've been on stage with shows like Equius. You've been in movies like Kill Your Darlings and Swiss Army. But, Daniel, I was texting with my brother and sister last night, and they would like me to show you their Harry Potter tattoos that they got. In my family, we get drunk and get tattoos. See the glasses?
Oh, that's very good.
With the lightning bolt? That's my sister Bridget.
They're not nearly as big as tattoos that I have seen.
Really?
Oh, yeah. People have got like full Voldemorts on them and
stuff.
Really? Yeah.
My brother and sister both have matching Harry Potter tattoos. They watched all 8 films and then got drunk and got those together.
That's great.
So they wanted me to show you those.
Thank you very much.
Have you seen a lot of Harry Potter tattoos?
I've seen a lot of Harry Potter tattoos. Some very good, like a lot of people have the Deathly Hallows, and a lot of people have glasses with a little scar. The one thing that I've seen that I really hate is some people have had my signature tattooed onto them after I have signed their arm. I did that once, and then I saw a girl like 3 years later, and I was like, oh, have I already signed for you? And she was like, no, this is a tattoo. Can you get my book? And I was like, and I have like horrible handwriting, and there's something really like, yeah, please don't do that. With anyone. You're not going to like us forever. Please don't. Yeah.
Do kids still recognize you as Harry Potter?
No. Sometimes, but like sometimes also I'm starting to get that thing where like parents will bring their children up and be like, this is Harry Potter. And the kids are looking and be like, no, that guy's old. They recognize that as Harry.
Right.
So this is different for them.
Like, welcome to the club.
My grandson's in love with the whole thing. He read all the books. He's a big fan.
I mean, they're amazing. And it's I was just saying to somebody backstage, they've become a thing of immense comfort for people. Yeah. Like, I've got friends who've told me that, particularly, like, if they're hungover, actually. One friend admitted to me recently, like, Harry Potter is like their go-to. When they're just feeling awful, there's something very comforting about this thing that was a part of your childhood. So it's nice to be a part of that.
Now, let's talk about your new play, because I went to see it, and I liked it a lot. It's very interesting and very timely play. It's called The Lifespan. Get new teeth and I'll be fine. Lifespan of a Fact. And you, Cherry Jones, Bobby Cannavale are in it. You play a fact checker.
Yes.
Bobby Cannavale plays an author who's a little fast and loose with the facts, and it's your job to check him out.
Yes, absolutely.
And, you know, and it was written in 2012, I believe.
Well, the book it was originally based on was written in 2012.
Which is amazing, because it's so really topical right now.
Well, we sort of get to have our cake and eat it a bit by being like, we're not an overtly political play. Like, we don't talk about the politics of the moment, or politics at all, really. It's about a fact checker checking this, an author of an essayist's work. But you can't do a play about fact and the nature of truth and things like that without it seeming political
at
this moment.
Particularly, they put it on stage right now. I think timeliness.
And there's something wonderful about, like, I love going to see theatre as a kid and then, like, discussing it with my parents afterwards and, like, talking about it. And I think this is a play that will get people talking about it. And I'm playing the guy who's very much on the side of facts, which is nice for me because I'm very much that sort of the argument I would mostly take for myself. But I think, it is good to see both sides of it presented in, I think, a pretty... hopefully sympathetic and very fun way. I'm making it sound very dry.
It's a comedy, really.
It's 85 minutes. It's really funny. It's short. You'll love it.
It is really funny. I mean, my husband and I went to see it, and we laughed throughout it. One thing that was interesting to me is you have this, you're Brit, right? You have this British accent. I did not see an inkling of an accent.
Oh, great.
Hear an inkling of it. It was no Harry Potter for me. It was just this character. When did you start to hone it? Because you were truly American in this.
Honestly, like, I think, and I can't speak for all British actors, but I think a lot of us have been honing them since we were kids.
Really?
And, like, I mean, I would give my, I was really into, as it was then, WWF, now WWE, as a kid, and, like, when those guys were American, so if I was playing with WWE action figures, I gave them American accents. Yeah. And, like, so I think I've also been told that I sound a lot like Chris Columbus, who directed the first two Harry Potter movies and was the American that I spent most time around early on. So I think apparently I sound like I'm from Ohio. I don't really know.
Yes, what that means. It was unbelievable. Yes. Yeah. You were terrific.
Oh, thank you very much. Well, good.
So as you know, there's something pretty special about a live audience. We've got one too. But at times, a phone can go off, someone can burp, or other bodily functions can happen.
Yes.
Which I'm sure happens during plays.
Yeah.
Does that ever get distracting, or are there any moments that you remember?
It doesn't get distracting. I did work with an actor once who used to stop the show when a phone would go off, and he would just, like, do that to me and just, like, turn to the audience and wait, which I was a teenager at the time, and I would find it just very hard not to laugh awkwardly in that situation. but we also had, like, the thing that is most distracting actually is, like, sometimes you'll get one laugh that you will hear above all the other ones, and it will be, like, slightly too loud, too long, and that inappropriate thing. And last night, yesterday, we had a woman in who I'm pretty sure was, like, a little bit drunk and was just laughing. I started off laughing and was really enthusiastic. And then at a certain point you're like, oh no, you're laughing at everything. Like these are not all jokes. You're just having a great time out there, but
better than the alternative, I guess.
Around you, absolutely better than no one laughing.
Right.
I'd rather have a room full of drunks laughing. That's a terrible thing to say.
Have you ever stopped in the middle and said, you know, shut up or turn that phone off?
No, I couldn't do that. I don't think I'd be too. Because I feel like it's like. If I was in that position, I would be mortified. Like, it's an embarrassing enough moment for them as it is, I think, most of the time. Bobby has heard people,
Bobby
I think...
Bobby Cannavale.
Yeah, he said, I think he said the other day that he had seen somebody actually, like, take a call, or, like, at which point, I think then you would be within your rights.
The only reason you should ever have a phone that's on is if your parent should go, in your pocket, and if it's a doctor, it should... Make a click and you can answer it.
Right.
That's the only time it should be on,
that's
y'all.
That's it.
In the theater.
Daniel, thanks for coming by. It's always
Thank
a pleasure to see
no
Daniel
worries.
Radcliffe. And if you're in New York, go see him in The Lifespan of a Fact. See? Not that hard to say. At Studio 54.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.